GOP tax plan downright crushes the NFL, costs them billions. There are plenty of epic things in the Republicans' new tax bill, and there's one part in particular you're going to love, if you're not a fan of the NFL at the moment due to its anthem kneeling practices. According to NBC Sports Pro Football Talk, part of the proposed tax package would eliminate tax breaks on municipal bonds, one way that cities often use to finance new stadiums for their teams. The proposed tax bill would target the tax exemption on municipal bonds, and those bonds have become a key piece of the $750 million in public funding that will build a new stadium for the Raiders in Las Vegas, the article reports. It's way too early to suspect that the provision, if it becomes law, would actually keep the stadium from being built, but it's definitely a potential complication for the NFL, and just another thing that a league suddenly under siege needs to worry about. Joe Lockhart, Vice President of Communications for the NFL, and the man behind the messaging from the Clinton White House during the Lewinsky perjury scandal, was definitely not all about that. "We believe that the construction of new stadiums and renovations of stadiums are economic drivers in local communities," Lockhart said. "If the idea is to promote economic growth, this would be a step backwards." Actually, not really. As Reason pointed out back in 2015, 86% of economists either agreed or strongly agreed with the statement that sports stadiums built in part or in full with public financing were bad investments for the taxpayers. And that's $4.7 billion of spending on NFL stadiums alone. I am not aware of a recent example of a major sports facility investment that earned anything approaching a reasonable return on capital or turned out to be self-financing in terms of tax revenues, University of California San Diego economist James Hamilton said. This probably should have been impetus enough to have a serious discussion about whether municipalities going into massive debt for new sports stadiums was a good idea, especially for conservatives. However, professional football's recent national anthem protests seem to have put public financing of sports facilities, especially as regards the NFL, under the microscope. In September, after the New Orleans Saints decided to participate in the anthem kneeling festivities, several Louisiana state legislators promised to take a look at the $165 million in the Saints' valuation that came from public funding, tax breaks and incentives. This included a sweetheart deal in which the Saints didn't pay any rent to play in the publicly owned Superdome, which just received $85 million in renovations from the state. Under the arrangement, the team kept all revenue from tickets, concessions and parking. "This is something we should have looked at a long time ago, in my opinion. However, if it takes a whole lot of anthem disrespecting to get conservatives to finally approve of changes on an issue that should have been looked at long ago, far be it from me to complain, especially if it costs the league billions of dollars.